Hello, welcome to the InfoZoom video series. Today we're going to be talking about reporting and dashboarding. My name is Stephen Pescalo. I'm president of SoftLake Solutions. What we're going to be talking about today is talking about reporting and how reporting is well integrated within Excel. I'll show you some examples there. I'll also show some use of graphing and also Windows docking or report docking, also a very nice feature within InfoZoom. So what you do is you first go to InfoZoom, and you bring in data. I almost always recommend going right to the overview. It's a nice, easier interface once you take a look at it. What I want to talk about today, though, is the results tab. So here there's really five different buttons that we're going to talk about today. The charting is very simple. The idea of InfoZoom, what you do is you just select the attribute that you want to analyze, and then you go ahead and hit whatever one you're interested in. Now, when you hit the charts, it by default, if you hit a single attribute, it brings up a pie chart. I like to go kind of directly to this 3D view. It kind of gives you a nice view of it. You can, you know, change the configuration of the chart. You can also have lots of different options. So here you can do pie charts that, you know, broken up, as well as donuts and bar charts and line graphs. A lot of different functions that exist within InfoZoom. You can also then resize it, so you can just grab the corner in here and just kind of resize it. And as always, whenever you're drilling into something, the characteristics of the charts then change. So one thing you could do with these charts is you can clip them into what we call report docking. And whenever you grab a chart, these little arrows will show up, and then you can dock your graph. So in this case, I can, you know, see here what my graph actually looks like. Sometimes you have to resize it. But the idea is that it makes it like a stable platform now that you can do your analysis. So as you're drilling through them, you can always still see how your graphics are changing. We're going to cover this in a later video series, but I'm going to create an attribute here. Here's, for example, claim amounts. Same principle. You select what you want to analyze. You hit your control button, and then what you want to analyze by. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and just do a sum and sort that sum. And I wanted to show how the graphics kind of change based upon the number of attributes that you actually select. So in this case, I've selected two. Again, going under results and charting, you can then see it provides more of a horizontal bar chart. And the reason why the default, you can always change it, of course, the characteristics here, but it's kind of nice that based upon the number of attributes you select, it changes this default. And same principle as here, you can resize it, and also things change as you drill through it here. Now, same, I want to dock these windows, so I can go ahead and pick it up again. You notice that you now have additional capabilities, either dock it on this side of the window, or if you go over here, you can see how it's changing over here. So I'm going to actually put it down below, and again, you might have to resize it so it looks a little bit nicer. But then I can then, same principle, as you drill through here, it then updates how your screens are actually looking. So the next one is interactive charting. Same principle. You just select what you want to see. Let me actually pick this one here. And then when you do an interactive chart, what happens is it goes ahead and creates an actionable drillable chart. So again, same principle, you can resize it, but then when you drill through it, so if I drill through here, for example, you can see that I'm actually drilling on the chart itself. Rather than having to drill here only, you can then drill on this actionable chart. And there's multiple ones, so you can drill, you know, again, hit the control button, and then you can pick on multiple ones. It also comes up with these nice features. So here's a pie chart. You can also change, just by hitting one button, you can change the characteristics here of what type of chart that you actually want to bring up. Another nice thing is over there, you can then provide different properties. including, you know, functions and colors are also supported as well. So the interactive chart is kind of a nice feature. And again, same principle, you can go ahead and dock these if you wanted to. So another option is to use Excel as a charting engine. Same principle, you select what you want to see, and then you can, and this would automatically export this out to Excel. Now, Excel, you can do a lot of different types of you know, formats and designs. So in this case, you can see what I picked here as kind of a design for this chart. What's nice about using the charting engine from Excel is that it also brings along your data. So here on the bottom here, you can see that your data is also comes along with the chart as well. So that's kind of nice. Another function is now talking about reporting. And so it kind of works in the same principle. What you do is you select what you want to analyze, and then you go ahead and do a report. Now, there are really two different types of reporting engines similar to charting, where you do, we can either use InfoZoom's own internal report engine. The principles are the same as what you're using in Excel. So if I wanted to do certain functions in the InfoZoom reports, I can. I can also do that same type of thing if I wanted to use Excel as well. So here then I'm going to go ahead and same principles. If I go ahead and do this selection here, you can see what my actually selection looks like. Now, same idea. This is a selection of a single attribute. If I want to do multiple ones, you can do that as well. And then you can see how it's changing here. So in this case, again, I might want to do a sum. I can then, in this case, 100 million, in this case, I'm looking at claims. So $100 million worth of claims, I can then drill into something. So if I wanted to drill into corporate, I can then see that my Excel is automatically updating as I am drilling into here. And that's a very nice feature. So if I go ahead and again drill, it brings up Excel. I can drill it again and it automatically tags or shows exactly what I'm into. And also, if you can see, it also updates my calculations as I'm doing them as well. And I like this example because if I was just using Excel for the analysis, I can see that I might want to focus on the Bronx to do my claims processing. But InfoZoom, again, provides a very nice, unique view to say, well, I only have 38 corporate customers, in this case in Queens, versus the 160 or the 203 in Manhattan. So I really want to focus on Queens just because proportionally I have a higher number of claims in Queens than I do in the Bronx. And that type of visibility is just kind of lost unless you're looking for it and program for it. You kind of miss that additional information, which could be very vital in this case when we're doing claims processing. So that's kind of what I want to talk about today. Look for additional videos on our YouTube channel. Thank you.